My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat.
Magandang umaga po.
Magpasalamat tayo sa Panginoong Diyos na tumawag sa atin para magkatipon sa pagdiriwang na ito ngayong umaga in the company of our presider, His Eminence Cardinal Anthony Pula, Bishop or Archbishop of Hyderabad, and the Archbishop of Lipa, Archbishop Gilbert Garcera, and Bishop Noli Buko, and the clergy of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Let me start my reflection by focusing on that line in the Gospel where Jesus says, "The harvest is rich." Alam niyo po minsan, ganoon ang nasabi ko sa isang magsasaka. I said exactly those words to one farmer one time as I was walking by his rice field. I observed his rice crop which was ready for harvest. Ang sabi ko, "Wow, Mang Pilising, it looks like it's going to be a big harvest for you." Natawa siya. He looked at me and he said, "Don't let your eyes fool you, Bishop. Akala nyo lang, malaki ang ani. It may seem like a big harvest to you, but actually, it's going to be a very poor harvest." And as he was talking, kumuha siya ng karet. He took his sickle, and he cut off a bunch of stalks of ripe grains of palay, and then showed them to me. Ang sabi niya, "Tingnan niyo po, look, more than half of these grains have nothing in them. They are just empty shells." Sa Tagalog, we know the distinction between palay and ipa. The palay is the full grain with the rice seed inside. The ipa is nothing but the shell. It is normally what remains after the rice is milled. But I did not know that it could actually happen, that a farmer could be milling what looks like full grains but are already empty shells even before the milling, because he has not succeeded in providing adequate care like fertilizing and irrigating. Pwede palang maging malnourished ang palay at pag nagbunga, ang kalahati walang laman. Well, kaya nga pala, minsan napagmamasdan natin sa mga countryside, you know, that very familiar image ng pagtatahip. The winnowing time, when the rice, yung palay, is put on a bilao, on the winnowing fan, and then it is tossed in the wind, at yung mabigat, babagsak sa bilao, yung walang laman, ililipad ng hangin. That is an image that has become very familiar in the Bible as a description of the final judgment, separating the grain from the chaff. Ihiwalay ang palay na may bigas doon sa palay, mukhang palay, pero walang laman. Sa araw na ito, ipinagdiriwang natin ang 137th birthday of Saint Padre Pio of Pietrelcina. And as many of you already know, si Padre Pio, he was endowed by God with the gift of clarity of spiritual vision that enabled him somehow to see what was in the souls of people. Some of them, even before they'd come to him for confession, parang nababasa ang kalooban. In the Gospels, you know, there are situations where Jesus is described in the same way by the evangelist. I wonder if you remember that passage where the Pharisees were reacting within themselves, silently, without verbalizing their reaction. And then the evangelist would have a parenthetical remark that would say, but Jesus knew what was in their thoughts. Nababasa niya ang kanilang kalooban. Actually, it does not have to be immediately attributed as a supernatural power. With a little bit of empathy, sometimes we really are able to read the thoughts, the hearts of our fellow human beings, because we can enter into spiritual communion with them. Of course, minsan tinatawag natin itong parang extraterrestrial power to read minds. Para bang yung X-ray vision ni Superman. But St. Paul, in our second reading today, is cautioning the members of the Roman community not to think of themselves more highly than they ought to think, just because they have such gifts. The charisms are not God's personal gifts to us. They are rather God's gift to the world through the church. He says, each one who has received the Holy Spirit has likewise received a gift, each according to the measure of faith that God has apportioned to him or to her. Sa Old Testament, marami ding mga kwento about spiritual vision. Perhaps you would remember the book of Samuel, where the Lord is reprimanding Samuel for not using the gift of spiritual vision that he was supposed to have been endowed with. Isa siyang propeta, and as a prophet, he had been gifted with that spiritual vision. You remember that story when Samuel was asked to find the Lord's anointed one among the sons of Jesse. And the prophet kept failing to spot the chosen one dahil masyado siyang nakafocus sa kanilang external appearance at pangangatawan. And remember what the Lord said to Samuel, ang tao pag tumingin, ang panlabas ang nakikita. Ang Diyos, tumitingin sa puso. Man looks and sees the external appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. And that is the spiritual vision I'm talking about, which Saint Padre Pio was endowed with. Well, I think that's the reason why many people flock to Saint Padre Pio for confession. He had that special gift of saying just the right words that would make the proud humble themselves. The words that would bring guilty consciences to repentance, to get them to express remorse and beg pardon for their sins so that they could be reconciled with God. Well, before St. Padre Pio, there were many people who felt a kind of spiritual nakedness. Tayong mga tao, kaya nating itago ang kalooban natin sa isa't isa. Pero ang Diyos, pwede mo bang lukuhin? He sees us inside out. And those who are beloved to God are endowed with the same spiritual vision. And Padre Pio was given that special gift. His piercing but loving eyes somehow made people experience God's understanding, compassionate, and forgiving gaze so that they voluntarily emptied their hearts to Him. After making acts of penance, they experienced fullness of grace upon absolution. Sa ating first reading, well, we are told about God's disappointment with the Israelite people. How quickly they were seduced by the golden calf, by the idol of power, prestige, and wealth, and how they turned their backs on the true God who liberated them from Egypt and made a covenant with them. Sabi nila, si Saint Padre Pio, you know, sometimes felt the same divine indignation. Ayon sa ating first reading, parang nagalit ang Panginoon sa nakita niya sa mabilis na paglimot ng kanyang bayan. Tayo rin madalas makalimot o mabilis makalimot. And Padre Pio also felt that divine anger and sometimes challenged people, especially when they went through the motions of confessing their little sins while covering up their hideous acts of idolatry in the way they lived their lives. And yet, his anger also quickly turned into mercy and compassion for the people's honest desire for God's grace in spite of their weaknesses and failures. Well, if Padre Pio comforted the afflicted, he also afflicted the comfortable. Perhaps you would remember that famous passage from Revelation chapter 3, where the Holy Apostle John says, "Kilala ko kayo. I know your works." I am sure sometimes you have felt that yourself when you are face to face with a man of God. God, as it were, addressing you, looking into your eyes, and saying, "Kilala kita. Huwag ka nang magpapanggap sa harapan ko. Alam kong nasa kaibuturan ng iyong puso." In Revelation 3, the apostle says, "I know your works. And you say, 'I am rich and affluent and have no need of anything else.' You don't realize how wretched, how poor, how pitiful you are, how blind and how naked." And I think that's the gift of spiritual vision that Padre Pio was endowed with. He could look into the hearts of people and see into them the emptiness of materialistic pursuits, especially of many people in modern societies. People whose lives look from the outside like full grains. Mukhang palay, pero walang laman. Walang mas kaawa-awang klaseng buhay na pwedeng isabuhay ang tao, kundi ang buhay na mukhang palay, pero ipa. Walang laman. To many people, Padre Pio sounded like the Apostle John who challenged them to discover true wealth. Hanapin, matagpuan ang tunay na yaman sa mundo. The apostle said, "I advise you to buy from me gold refined by fire so that you will become truly rich, and white garments to put on so that your shameful nakedness may not be exposed, and buy ointment to smear on your eyes so that you may see." Maraming tao nagtatanong, bakit dumadagsa ang libo-libo, daang libo, milyong-milyon katao dito sa dambanang ito. This shrine of Padre Pio. I hear that in the previous years, umaabot ng 7 milyon at nitong huli, ilang buwan pa lang nakararaan, nakabilang na sila ng 4 na milyon. Ibig sabihin, mayroong batubalani ang lugar na ito. And sometimes, I look at people in deep prayer in the shrine. And I see people fervently praying. Some of them almost desperate about their needs. And I'm sure many of you are also sometimes tempted to think that God is far or God is asleep. Natutulog ba ang Diyos? Nakikinig ba siya? Alam ba niya ang pinagdaraanan ko? And it is to those people that Saint Padre Pio often addressed himself as a source of consolation. Many times he reduced people to tears when he brought them to hear the same words that are both disturbing and consoling at the same time. The words of the Holy Apostle John in Revelation 3, "Those whom I love, I test and chastise. Ang mga tunay na malapit sa kalooban ko ay sinusubok ko at dinadalisay." Sa araw pong ito, on this day of the 137th birthday of this much-loved saint, my prayer for you, dear brothers and sisters, is that through the intercession of Saint Padre Pio, the Lord grant you also the spiritual vision that will allow your hearts and souls to see through the emptiness of Satan's promises. May He inspire you instead to follow only Jesus Christ, our Lord and Master, by whose total emptying of self, we alone can discover the fullness of God's grace. Amen.